to another episode of the ongoing history of beer. I'm your host, as usual, Tiffany. And today in studio, I'd love to welcome Steel Wheel Brewery, which consists of, not just of, but today we've got Cindy and Harold joining us.
Hello.
Thank you. Yeah. I feel like we're overdue for revisiting.
Very good. We're excited.
Yes, I appreciate you guys being able to come in today. So you're a little bit closer than someone else I've had or a few of the others I've had on here. We're kind of going into the backyard of the studio somewhat. So why don't you tell everyone where you're from, where we can find you. We'll start out with that.
And sure. So we're the Brant County's first and only craft brewery. So we're an on-farm brewery. There's a handful of us in Ontario. So we grow hops. We have 2 acres of hops, and then we use those hops and brew the beer right on the property.
Yay. Yeah. Powerline Road?
Powerline Road, right. 105 Powerline Road.
105 yep. Powerline Road.
Yes.
Beautiful sign out front. You can't miss it.
Nice. Yes, you can't miss it. There's a giant steel wheel.
Yes. Yep,
from a steam engine.
So. Yeah. So tell us a bit about, I don't know where to start because I feel like there's so many really unique facts about your place, but let's start with the name and maybe we'll dig into that whole steam engine.
Sure.
So we have a passion for vintage and antique farm equipment. So we have 2 operating steam engines and several steel-wheeled, very early tractors, and lots of stationary hit-and-miss engines.
So cool.
That's been part of a way of life for us for a long time. So we decided to incorporate that into the brewery, and several times throughout the year we'll have equipment out and operating. Typically Father's Day weekend is a good time to come out and see something running. We also do a hop harvest party. This year it's going to be on
August 8th?
The 8th of August, and
we'll
have
birthday.
A lot of stuff. Oh, yeah.
That's why we picked that date.
Yeah. I think she'd really like to come out, so I'll make sure I bring her out that day.
For sure.
So you guys have a hop yard in the back of the brewery, and that's been running longer than you've been open pouring beer for people. But how long have you guys been growing hops for? Or essentially, I know there's a bit of stages that's involved in that.
Yes, because we started with a nursery bed to see if we could grow hops and what types of hops we could grow.
Okay.
And then after that, when we kind of got an idea of what that was about 75 plants, we put in 2 acres, which is 1,500 plants.
Wow.
We've been growing hops. I think it's in our 5th or 6th year this year.
2015 is when the first section of the yard went in, and then a big chunk of it went in 2016, and then just a couple more rows in 2017.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
So now you're juggling running a hop yard.
Right.
As well as a brewery.
Yes. So yeah, we have 7 varieties of hops in the hop yard.
Right.
So that we can kind of have a little bit of a bunch of different kinds of hops to help us with flavoring our beers.
Yeah. So are all the hops in your beer coming from you guys, or do you sometimes order in as well other ones to maybe fill the gaps, or I guess the varieties that you can't grow on site as
so
well?
So about 85% of the hops in the beer are from the farm, that we grow, and then we still have to get some in. Some are trademarked or proprietary hops, so we can't grow those, So the companies that develop them have, rightly so, trademarked them because they put a lot of energy in them. So
those
really
big
aroma hops like Mosaic and Citra and Simcoe and such are proprietary, and we still have to buy those ones in.
Okay.
And then also you buy in other hops because you want to have some different flavors in your beer.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right. There's so many out there now, too. I don't even know the numbers. You guys might know, but it's
huge.
It's something I've been trying to focus a little bit more on, too, is what each hop variety brings to a beer, because I think some of them are a bit more simple or just, that citrus flavor, but then some of them go really deep. So trying to figure out what hops are in what beers. But I think I started to try and focus on that a little bit this year, and it was like, this is way too much information, and then I would just drink all the beer and enjoy it.
Yeah, we typically have 8 varieties on tap, and 5 to 6 of them are 100% our hops. And then the other ones will be dry hopped with something a little more exotic that we can't grow.
Right. So that's taking us now into the tap room. So you guys have a really special tap room as well. It was a standing house before, and you revamped it? Is that the right way?
Yeah. So it was an old farmhouse, and we've renovated it to be a tap room so people can come in and enjoy a beer on the property. So we have a bar in there and some tables, and some of the old stuff is still there from the original house, which was built in about the late 1800s, I think the original farmhouse was.
Yeah. And you guys have done a lot of this yourselves.
Yes, we have. So, impressive. We both worked, full-time. We did all the renovations and put in the hop yard, and then work to open the brewery.
Yeah.
So,
Good for you. A labor of love.
It is.
Right?
It is.
Working
yes.
together.
Yes.
And I like that it's the farmhouse feel, but I think a lot of breweries have that now a little bit, but yours is actually a farmhouse.
Right.
And actually, like, it's like the legit farmhouse feel, not just the decor going on
inside
as well.
Right. And some people say it's like sort of sitting in our kitchen or sitting in someone's kitchen,
yeah.
you know, at a party where you always kind of congregate in the kitchen. So people seem to gather in our place.
That's a great way to describe it.
Yeah. It's just, they bring food because we don't serve food, but you can bring food into the brewery.
Right.
So then they bring food and they all sit with their friends and have a beer and share a meal. And it's very, you know, lovely that way, that we are the spot that people gather or people take a pause in their day and come in and relax.
Right,
so,
right.
Yeah.
And a patio too, I guess, for our sunny days.
Yes.
Or not, they come throughout the winter now, it seems too. So
that's
good.
Mm-hmm. We've had some people on the patio.
The past 2 weekends, there have been people on the patio.
Yeah. True Canadian spirit.
That's right.
Yeah,
that's right.
So we've got about a minute left before we go to our first break and start cracking some beers as well. So are you the brewer, Harold?
I take part in the brewing. Mm-hmm. We have hired a graduate from Niagara College, Mitch Tuckey.
Excellent.
He's the lead at the brewing. We work together. I usually get up early in the morning, put on the mash, and then go back up and have my breakfast. And then Mitch comes in and starts the transfer.
Cool.
We work together on recipe development.
Nice.
Mitch does a lot of the packaging and the cellaring work in the brewery. So
Yeah. Good. And I like this Niagara. I feel like there's such great, great students coming out of there as well to do stuff. So do you find like they're well prepared as far as the pack? Like they're getting every kind of aspect and
absolutely.
A nice preparation to kind of step into that role and just a little bit of guidance, right?
That's correct. Yeah. Mitch came right out of the college and joined our team. And, you know, he was on the ground running right from day one.
Cool.
Knew what to do. And it's worked out really well.
Awesome. Awesome. And, like I said, we're going to head to break.
Okay.
So when we come back, we're going to dig into a growler of beer that you bought us. And we are going to talk a little bit more about what styles you guys brew there, what's going on, maybe some upcoming events, and just chat a little bit more about Steel Wheel.
Great.
All right.
Sounds
awesome.
Good. We'll be right back.
It was our 35th anniversary. To celebrate, we were on our way to Mama Rosie's, where we had our first date. That's when we heard coming from the radio. So we stopped and listened. It helped us get to safety. So when I think of our anniversary, because now we have even more to celebrate.
Story. It felt like there was something else going on.
We're gonna do things differently this time.
I am not crazy.
I think Nick has a hold on you.
Don't play this game with me.
It's too easy.
He's capable of anything.
And you aren't.
The Sinner. New story Thursday at 10 on Showcase.
We were born in Canada. We spoke English. On the streets, we weren't welcome. But on the field, we were the assassin. Vancouver's champions. Everyone cheered for us. Our people had a voice. Then Canada declared war on Japan. They took us from our homes, called us enemies, forced us into camps. But we brought the game with us. Baseball helped get us through the internment.
The Vancouver Asahi were among the 22,000 Japanese Canadians interned during the Second World War. The team never played another game.
We'll be right back.
your host still, Tiffany. And again in studio, I have Steel Wheel Brewery, Cindy and Harold joining me.
Awesome.
So thanks again.
Yes,
thanks again for being here.
You're welcome.
Taking the afternoon off.
Cheers. Yeah.
And cheers to you.
Cheers. Yeah.
Beautiful. Oh, it's delicious. So, what is this? Tell me what's in my glass. Should rename the show.
We're drinking Station Pale Ale today.
It's
easy drinking pale ale, kind of gateway to an IPA. It has a hint of bitterness in the finish and dry hopped with lots of mosaic hops, so you really get that nice juicy aroma when you take a sniff. Yeah.
It has a nice malt backbone to it as well, but not overly sweet.
Right. Yeah.
I really enjoy this. I don't think I've had this one in a while. It's one of your, would you call it a flagship or one of your regular ones?
Yeah,
or?
It's one that we have on tap more often than not. Mm-hmm. We change what we dry hop it with, but yeah, it's around quite often. It's become very popular.
Yeah, good. So do you guys have a certain style that you showcase, or are you kind of all across the board as far as what you like to brew?
I think our style is, let's try something new.
I like it.
So we brew a lot of ales. Ales are what a lot of breweries feel comfortable with, and they do have a shorter production time,
yes.
So you can get more to the tap. We have 8 taps, so we generally have all 8 taps full of things, and we range from a nice easy drinking blonde with a low bitterness unit to our double IPA, which has very high bitterness. So it's quite a range, and we usually have a sour on tap, almost always
one
have
or two,
IPA on tap. So we kind of have a few things that we generally have, and after that it's a bit of a free-for-all.
Nice. So. I like that ability. I mean, it is cool to see some breweries that have like a focus on certain kinds, but I do like that choice because every day is a little bit of a different mood too,
right?
Or weather or whatever it is that you want to drink.
Yeah, and usually people find something on the tap that they like. Even if they're new to craft beer, we try to have a fairly mild beer so that we can introduce them, because craft beer is sometimes something that you need to ease into if you're not used to drinking it. So we try to have something mild. Sometimes wine and cider drinkers like our sours because they're our least beery beer, really is what it is.
So, that's true.
So it tastes the least like beer, and so people are quite surprised that they enjoy that. So we like to have that kind of variety to hopefully, you know, help out the new customers and also the ongoing customers.
Yeah, so nice and approachable.
Mm-hmm.
It's important.
Mm-hmm.
I call it hop bullying. You don't want to hop bully everyone into it.
Yeah, right. And sometimes that's people's first introduction to craft beer is a really hoppy beer, and then they're sure they don't like craft beer.
Yeah.
But really, you know, there are a lot of varieties out there, and you really need to continue to taste it to find out what your style is, what's in your steel wheelhouse.
Yeah, amazing. And you just won an award this week with your double IPA.
Yes, we did.
Yay.
Yeah.
So tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah. Do you want to talk about
that? Sure. So every year, OMAFRA puts on a competition, and it's a pairing between Ontario brewers and Ontario hop growers. So they have to be made with 100% Ontario hops. And this year we took second place in the competition. It's judged at the Fruit and Vegetable Conference in Niagara.
So fun.
Niagara Falls. Yeah, it's
very good. I love
that
beer's involved with that, as it should be, right? But it's a whole
absolutely.
Other community.
Yeah, because it brings the farm to glass kind of thing that we promote. So, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Fantastic. And would this be, because you used to do this competition before you even had a brewery, right? So would you do the hops in the competition before, but now you're like partnering with yourself? Is that?
We actually partnered with Bickle Farms, Valley Hops out of Eastern Ontario. The current registration process for the on-hop competition doesn't allow you to have the same name for the hop farm and the brewery.
I think that makes sense.
Yeah.
And that's kind of maybe a fun, I don't know if challenge is the right word, but like it gets you to go outside the box a little bit too and work with someone else.
Exactly.
That has
local
hops.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yes.
I like that competition. I did have a chance to judge it several years ago, I remember. And it was really fun because like hops they're changing. It depends on the season you have, right? Mm-hmm. It's not something that you are getting the exact same hop every year,
right?
Just because it's planted, right? You would know way more about this part of the weather and everything. But
absolutely,
it's kind of cool to see how a beer can change year to year, but also a little bit nerve-wracking. Would it be too like?
It is, and you're limited, you know, especially with an IPA style of beer, you're limited to what hops you can use. We can't use the Mosaics or the Citras or the Galaxies because you can't grow them. We can't get the plant stock.
Right.
So you're stuck with the more traditional hops, and it's very challenging to draw those intense flavors from those more mainstream hops.
Interesting. So when you say more traditional, do you mean more of like a noble variety or just ones that aren't adding all that like bitterness and
Not so much the bitterness, but the fruity flavors.
Okay.
You know, it's hard to get something that has a lot of citrus or melon or stone fruit in it, you know, something that really pops.
Hmm.
So we have to go back to, you know, our Cascades and Columbus and things like that. So
so partnering with Valley Farms was good because he grows a Mackinaw hop, which is very he's the only one in Ontario that grows it, and so it brings those flavors that we need in an IPA to the table, and it's grown in Ontario, so the Mackinaw hop was what we were really happy to use.
Cool.
Mm-hmm.
Is it an IPA heavy competition?
Every year they pick a style.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah,
that's
yeah.
Right.
Every
so
year
that
they
was
pick
the style.
A style.
This year was a double IPA.
Yes. Yeah, so that was
crazy.
A tough one with, with Ontario.
Not a surprise,
hops.
But still, that's a big beer.
That is big beer, yeah. So you have to be confident to brew that. And,
the
and
balance,
they give
right?
you the criteria for color and taste and, you know, alcohol content. And
okay.
So, yes, you have to meet all the criteria and then as well,
So somewhat from the style guide, I guess you're following.
Yes,
but
yes,
then.
Yes,
okay.
Exactly. And then they have judges that judge it, and then they narrow it down to four beers, and then they retest them all, and then
That's fun.
So it was good.
Good. Mm-hmm. So we just have under a minute left already, if you can believe it or not.
Mm-hmm.
So where can we find you online to kind of keep up with what's going on there too, or any events that you guys have, or these awesome steam engine days, because I've seen them and it's so cool to go out and visit.
Well, thank you. So we're on Facebook and Instagram, and we post anything that's coming up, and then our website is updated continually. So our beers on tap are on there. We're running winter courses right now, so mostly non beer related courses. So we have lots of courses going on about different topics. And then the new beers that we're releasing, we always post on Instagram and Facebook.
Fantastic. Well, thank you again so much for joining from Steel Wheel.
Yes.
It's nice to have you guys in
cheers.
Studio.
Cheers.
Big cheers to you.
Cheers.
And we'll see you at the next episode. Up next is Dre.